Okay guys, welcome to the Nail Zone for you. I'm here to do a quick tutorial for you guys on this look here. A lot of you guys asked on the 3D encapsulated or 3D flower, sorry. I went blank for a minute. So hopefully you can see this on your frame. So I already prepped my nail, shaped it. I'm gonna do it on this finger here. This is my other, all of these acrylics is my acrylic mix that I made, my custom color acrylic mixes. Okay, so, but let's jump right into it. I'm gonna just do it on this middle finger here. I'm gonna try to recreate this 3D flower nail. So all the things that you need to have, once you prep your nail, shape it to the desired shape, you're gonna have white acrylic. If you wanna do a two-tone flower, you can do so. Using white or whatever color you prefer of acrylic. I did get a question from a young lady on Facebook asking about, can you do a 3D flower or on a natural nail plate? You can, okay, to answer your question, you can. I personally would recommend that, because when you want to remove that specific design, then you may damage the natural nail when you fouling off the current design, okay? Now, if it's more of a design that you don't mind, you soak it off, it's whatever. But now if you use color acrylic to do your 3D flower, I'm not sure if it would stain the nail bed, so if you do that, I recommend that you lay a thin layer of clear acrylic on the natural nail bed. And then you don't even have to worry about the tip, because we're gonna just build the flower from there, okay? It's your choice to bring it all the way up or just do it on, just put a thin layer of clear acrylic just on the natural nail plate or the natural nail. Okay, so I have my base color. So I have my white here, so I'm gonna just jump right into it. And I also have been asked another question about, can you do this design with gel? I have not done it with gel. I'm sure you can. I know they have this gel out. It's called gummy gel or gum gel. So it's more thicker than gel, so you can play with it. It's really, really thick. Like you can just roll it in your hand and form and then place it on the nail and then press it out. I think with using alcohol. I'm sorry, alcohol. So, I have not tried it, but if you guys are interested, I think I know a place that does sell it. I will put a link below. If you are interested, just let me know and I will do that. Some people do make their own gum gel using gel and acrylic powder. I don't know what the ratios is to that, so that's something that you have to do your research on. I haven't looked into it so far. But the things you're gonna need is your white. That's what I'm using today, is my white acrylic powder, regular monomer. When I first started doing 3D encapsulated nail art or 3D nail art to cure faster because I was a newbie, I mixed half and half of acetone and monomer, okay? But this is just regular old monomer. So let's jump right into it. I'm gonna try my best to stay in frame. So I have my brush here, my 3D nail art brush. I got this off of Amazon a few years ago. And the name on here, it's Pure Color Nail Art number 5. I love, 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 love this 3D acrylic brush. Okay, so I'm gonna go into my monomer and I'm gonna just pick up a small bead, like so, if you can see that, the size. And I'm just gonna just start up here. Just start, you know, whatever you feel comfortable with. I'm just gonna jump right into it. Sometimes you have to let the acrylic set. Since my acrylic is curing pretty fast, I'm just gonna just jump right into it. So I'm gonna spread this out and just basically make a smile. or you the best as you can. It's not gonna be perfect. I'm gonna point it down like you know how you're writing with a pen. I'm gonna use the tip and the body of the bristles and pull it down. And then pull out and pull it all the way out, all the way around. Just press so you form your petal. So hopefully you guys can see that. And please try to make it as thin as possible, but not too thin that it fades away. And try not to work with it too much because the more you press into it, the more it loses effect. Okay, so I'm gonna go back into my liquid, pick up another bead. As you can see there. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and just start down here so I can get an idea of how big my flower is gonna be or how I like it. Now, I'm not saying this is the right way or this is the only way, but this is the way that works for me. I'm gonna try to make sure I'm not blocking any views so you can see everything that I'm doing. Okay, my brush is still a little too wet. So bring it all the way out. You're forming your petals to make your flower or rose. I'm not saying I'm the best of the best, but I just got this, you know, to where I like it. So you guys want to know, so I'm putting it out there, showing you guys how I achieved this look. All flowers may not come out to look the same. But more you practice, the easier it becomes for you. And I do apologize for my lighting. And also, you know, my setup is not all that great because I don't make money of recording these videos. So you're gonna make sure you angle your brush like you're writing, but use the body of the bristles of your brush and press down to form your petals. Press out and down, out and down. Okay, see that? So it's almost like C's. You're making C's. Pick up another bead. And be careful not to put your flower or your ball too close to the cuticle area, the free edge, and the side walls or the sides of the nail. Try not to do that, okay? Because then you're running into a problem when it's time to encapsulate your design, that you have a bulk of acrylic. I mean, a serious big bulk of acrylic that you don't want to be doing all that fouling, or you have like this huge hump that you may not be comfortable with or like to have on your design, on your nail. Again, so now I'm coming too close to the side wall. I'm going to push down and press out, push down, press out, so it brings it back in instead of all the way out to the edge of the nail. So now you see, you start seeing a flower here. It's starting to come together. Again, another bead. It's only take a little bit of product, just a little bit. This brush holds a lot of liquid, just a little bit of product. And again, like I said, you can find this brush on Amazon. I think some young ladies who have like stores on Facebook, they sell them as well. You have to check with them. But I did get mine from off of Amazon. I'll hold it down, press down, down, and then I'm bringing it around. I'm trying not to block the view, guys. okay. I think I'm happy with that. And then you just continue on. You want to make sure you start to close off your flower. You don't want to have, okay, the bead is too dry. You don't want to have a big open gap there that it won't look like a flower. So I'm going to come around this way. And I'm going to try to spread this out as much as I can. You just need a small bead, just a small bead. Press out. There we go. Okay, now we're going to close off our flower. Another, lost my bead. Okay, another small bead. Let it sit a little bit. Okay. I'm gonna make your smile. Just a small one, you don't need a large one. Just start closing it out. And again, use the body of the brush. To form your petal. Okay. Another small one. And I think I'm gonna put it right there. Maybe a little bigger. You can always go back and add just a little bit more of powder. And then we're gonna just, I'm just gonna do a small petal. The petals start getting smaller and smaller. Smaller and smaller as you close your flower. Press out and around and around and around. See, like you're holding a pen, but you're just gonna press out and around. Okay. So, let's see. I'm gonna look at it, make sure everything looks fine, I'm happy with it. Now we're gonna put our center ball. And actually, that may be a little bit too much. Okay, there we go. Then we're gonna put our center ball. You can always pull it back in. I used too much product. I didn't want the ball to be that big because I don't wanna have a hump there. So I'm gonna take it, point straight down into that center ball. Make sure your point is there. I'm gonna press it in like a dot. Then I'm gonna stay in that dot and I'm gonna make a donut, slow circles. So I made my donut. Then I'm gonna stay in that center and press my donut out and down. Out and down. Out and down. Out and down. See, there we go. We have our closure of our flower. And we're gonna do the same thing here because we can fit another closure there. Okay, so we're gonna place it about here that I feel comfortable with. Let this sit for a minute. Again, take the point of your brush. You're gonna go straight down to the center. It's still a little bit too wet. Okay. Just do your little donut. Do your small circular motion in the center again, right? You're gonna press out, 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 down and out, down, out, down, out. Now we have two closure. I think I'm fairly happy with this look. Hopefully you guys like it. I think I'm fine where it's at. I don't want to overdo it. You overdo it, then it starts to look like mush. So I think I am happy with that. So let's close up our product. We're done using the white. You can also use micro beads or caviar beads, as some people would call it. Here I have glitter inside of mine. So you can use your glitter, or if you can use micro beads. So I'm gonna take a little bit of clear acrylic. Okay, I'm gonna take a little bit of clear acrylic, just a dot. We don't need very much of it. I'm gonna place it right in the center. Then I'm gonna pick up some of my beads that I have floating around here. And the liquid on the brush will pick them up. Okay. Can't get them. Okay, there we go. Gonna place that in the center of that donut that we created, or the closure of your flower. Gently press down. Okay. There we go. Then we're gonna do another one in the other closure. Just a dot of acrylic. That's all you need. Pick up some caviar beads, micro beads, and put it in the center of that. And that's all it needs. So we have our flower now. You can actually take a little bit, if you have like openings, like empty or bald spots, and add just a small amount of caviar beads if they're small enough. You don't want to add even close to the cuticle, because when it comes to fouling, you might foul into your beads and it will leave like little pivots in there. So let me see. I think I can add a little bit. Like, let's see here. I add a little bit up in here. This is your creation, so whatever you feel that works for you, don't be afraid to do it. Let's see. Add a little bit more here. A kidnapper. Yeah, I know. I caught you in the corner of my eye. Yeah, that's my husband. He's been pacing around looking for my glue dry. The glue dry spray. I forgot the name of it. Okay, so I think that looks good. What you think, guys? Okay, we'll take, just gonna add a little bit more somewhere else so it don't look so plain. You know, just give it a little oomph. Like I'm being a little dangerous here, because I'm placing it where I know it's gonna be where I'm going to be fouling at, but I'm going to try to keep it off that sidewall. So when I go fouling, I'm going to press it down. So when I go foul it, I won't have any issues. I won't foul into these beads. Okay, I think I'm just going to leave that Okay, that don't look right. So while it's still wet, I can just wipe it right off. See? Just right, wipe right off. I'm sorry, guys. Okay, I'm just gonna leave it as is. I don't wanna risk putting anything along the cuticle on the sides of the nail or put any more at the tip because that needs to be thin. Okay, so I'm gonna move this out the way. Now we're gonna jump into encapsulate. Okay, sorry guys if this video is long, but I wanted you guys to see every step. Okay, so let's start encapsulating this. Get a nice size bead, tilt the finger downwards so the product will run downwards. You want to make sure the cuticle stay thin so it'll look natural. You won't have that huge hump where it doesn't need to be at. But you do want the apex to be thick enough that your client won't have any issues of their nail breaking off where the nail enhancement and a natural nail meet. This is a pretty long nail, so I have to do it in parts. I don't want to risk it doing it in one ball method because I'm not very good at that. I'm still learning that one ball method. Hopefully my lighting is good enough so you guys can see. Make sure you clean up them side walls or the sides of the nail. Get a good coverage because we're gonna foul this top layer. And I also did get a question about another good way of making it look more crystal clear. Tongue tie, sorry guys. You can use gel. Use gel. That's too much product. Use gel and to encapsulate instead of acrylic, and the 3D art will pop a lot more or a lot better if you're not very good at laying acrylic. I think, yeah, when you use the gel, it pops a whole lot better. Because you can see all the dimensions of the flower. I think I'm happy with this. I'm gonna make sure I don't have product underneath the nail. I can't stand when I have that problem. Okay. I think I'm happy with this. I don't see anything under the nail. Let me close this off so I don't have any accidents. So let's check and make sure we don't have any product under here. No product running down. We have a small amount here. which, you know, with a file you can go into it. Okay, I got it up. Okay. Yeah, you have to be very careful with that. Watch your sides. And when you bring your acrylic down, it runs under the free edge. Okay, so let me close this up, guys. Okay. Always clean your brush after each service. I'm gonna let this finish setting. And when it's finished setting, I'm gonna go ahead and file. Oh, guys, I hope I went out. I think I was out of frame the whole time. I hope not. I'm gonna let it set. And I'll be right back after I file. And you'll see the finished results. Okay, so now I've filed it, buffed it, and reshaped it. So this is our product here. I'm gonna go ahead and we can go ahead and do our gel top coat. We'll finish. Gel finish. Okay, I wasn't prepared. So I have my IBD. In case you guys wonder what I use. I do use CND products, okay? The pink that I used was my custom-made acrylic, color acrylic, but I'm going to use this here. Let me see. How far am I in frame? There we go. I'm going to use this here. All right. So, you guys know what I'm using. I use CND retention. Retention Plus powder and liquid. And the white was just some white I had laying around because I don't have any more white. But I am using this white. So if you guys want to know where I got the white from, I can leave a link below. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and just finish this off so we can be done. Okay. Make sure you get this size real good. You don't want to have any bald spots. Seal it in real good. And, oh, that looks beautiful. You see the difference once you put the gel top coat on there? Cap it. Even though it's not really neat because it's all acrylic, but you don't want to have it dull at the free edge or at the tip. So I think that's good enough. Alright, so I'm gonna close this up. Let me get my lamp. And I'm gonna cure this. Very careful not to bump it. I'm gonna cure mine for 60 seconds. Those are finished product. And I'm loving it. And then, you know, of course you can, you know, put your cuticle on, your cuticle oil on. You know, for your client, you know. So they don't walk around with ashy cuticles. Busted knuckles. But, yeah, so there we go. So hopefully, guys, you love it. Hopefully, it helps. Help you guys. And like I said, this, you know, it might not be the right way, but this is my method. This works for me. And if you guys like, you know, you can try it and see if it works for you. All right, guys, until next time, thank you for coming to the Nail Zone for you.